Starting off with the collection, I have a new Pac-Man hat. I got this on eBay for a good price, and it has all four ghosts and the Pac-Man logo. And this whole entire hat has a lot of Pac-Man and ghosts on it as a pattern. I actually like this hat, it's pretty cool. Here is something that I got at Ross. Yep, these are Pac-Man socks. I got two pairs. This one has the cherries, the ghosts, and the Pac-Man, and they do it in a pattern. And this one has the three ghosts and Pac-Man on it. These were the last ones on the shelf. You know the guy in Hobbit who said, "My precious!" That's what I was like when I first saw these. I was holding them in my grasp. I didn't want anyone to take them. But yeah, these are pretty cool looking socks. I'll probably wear these in the winter. Here right here is something really special. I got this at Target, and this is my arcade cabinets. So I got the Pac-Man one. They didn't have a Miss Pac-Man one, unfortunately, but I'll find one soon. And here we have is the screen, the controls, and the sides of it is the classic arcade design. So I'll probably give you a little bit of gameplay out of this, but first I'm gonna show you a little montage of the little paper cutouts that I got from the packaging that I put on the wall.
Yeah, you pretty much get the idea. It plays like the original game, but it's smaller than an original cabinet. It's a bit hard to control because the joystick is really small and tiny that even a doll can play with this. So the farthest I've ever gone to in this version of the game is the apples. And to tell you guys, I've been practicing a little bit on the GameCube on Pac-Man World 2. I've actually gone to the Galaga item. But you know what they say, practice means perfect. So yeah, that's pretty much all I have to show you. So thank you all so much for watching, and I hope you have a Pac-tastic day. Bye!